As 6 o'clock struck, she hung back, to Spotty Ronnie's evident frustration. She couldn't afford to bump into Dada as he left the building. At last she was on the tram, willing it to go faster. Alighting at Wilbraham Road, she hurried to the agency, throwing a prayer heavenwards as she hurried upstairs.
"Look who it is," Miss Lever said. "I say, are you all right? Have a seat."
She poured out her troubles. "So I need another post before my notice is up." Catching a look passing between the two, she stopped. Would they have nothing for her? Miss Kennett indicated a door in the corner.
"Be a duck and pop the kettle on, would you? I know it sounds a frightful cheek, but Lever and I need a private word."
She found a minuscule kitchen with a sink, a gas ring, and a couple of shelves bearing a surprising quantity of crockery. When she brought a tray through a few minutes later, she was greeted by smiles.
"That letter you wrote us was jolly good," said Miss Kennett. "Better than most we receive. And your experience sounds just what we're after for a new post, right here with us. We need an efficient body to run the office. Lever and I are fine at pointing women in the right direction, but we're not so hot on record-keeping and so forth."
"We need someone to keep us in line."
Miss Lever leant forward coaxingly.
"Would you give it a go?"
"So," Lillian sniffed, "they want a dog's body."
"I'll be responsible for the clerical side of things," Mary explained. "First, I'll get the office routines up to scratch."
"Like I said, dog's body. Two upper-class ladies playing at work in a need in a skivvy."
"It's not skivvying. It's responsible work. Important, too. Helping women find decent jobs."